¿cómo están? Bienvenidos otra vez a mi canal. Hoy tenemos a alguien que se nos coló en el set. No, no es que no es cierto. No, hoy tenemos una invitada muy especial. Ella es Luisa. Ella es mi cuñada. Bueno, en realidad es la prometida de mi cuñado. Y bueno, hoy les vamos a hablar acerca de cuando llegamos las dos a Alemania, porque ella es mitad americana, mitad italiana. Ha vivido en Estados Unidos y en Italia. Y yo soy mexicana. He vivido en México. Entonces, bueno, acerca de, desde nuestros puntos de vista, ¿qué nos costó más trabajo de adaptarnos aquí en Alemania? ¿Qué fue como que lo más que nos dio como el shock cultural? Entonces, se lo queremos compartir, espero les interese, así que comenzamos. Muy bien, así que va a haber una voz muy sexy, hermosa, la voz de mi esposo. Nos va a estar haciendo las preguntas. Él nos va a estar haciendo las preguntas en alemán, ella va a estar contestando en italiano, yo voy a contestar en inglés y les voy a poner subtítulos en español. No, no es cierto. No es cierto, no se crean. No va a haber un mix medio loco de idiomas. No, todo va a ser inglés, pero les voy a poner aquí abajito todos los subtítulos en español. Entonces, hacemos ahorita el switch de idioma. Primera pregunta.
What was an example of cultural shock when you guys came to Germany?
So, for me, the most shocking thing that I realized about Germany when I came here was that it's actually really, really similar to where I'm from in the US, which is the Midwest. And in Germany, we have the Autobahn, and when you're driving on the Autobahn, it literally seems like
crazy.
Yeah, it seems crazy. It seems crazy, but it also seems like exactly like in the US, except in the US, they're driving a little crappier. And like here in Germany, they're driving like pros,
so like more decent.
Yeah, exactly. But that was probably the most shocking thing, because I thought I would see some like major differences with the US and with Germany,
but from Italy I guess that changes a lot. Yeah, because I think the way of driving in Italy and in Germany is like completely
help. No, but it's true, like you're right, because in Italy we have not so rules of the road that we have in Germany, because in Germany you go on the Autobahn and it's like it's a system and you drive.
Everything in Germany is a system.
It's a system and you don't mess with the system. But you literally like have to, you know, if you're gonna go fast, go in the fast lane. If you're done going fast, go back in the right lane. And it's just like in Italy, in Italy you just have a little bit more just more chaos, kind of. It's like pretty, it's not as predictable, I guess, as it is on the German Autobahn.
It happens as well in Mexico.
I can imagine driving in Mexico would be
it's also
similar.
Pretty crazy. But well, for me, like the most shocking things is, well, first of all, the language.
Oh,
because
yeah.
Jesus, I swear, I was learning German a little bit, kind of, in Mexico, and then I was like, I'm super pro in this, like my German, like
got this.
Yeah, exactly. I got this. Then I arrived in Germany and I realized I don't got it.
I don't got it.
I didn't get it.
Yeah.
So it was pretty much that I didn't understand like anything apart from hello.
Yeah.
Tickets.
That's
true.
I feel like here they're mumbling a lot.
Yeah,
you know?
That's true. And they have a lot of like dialects. Like they call it dialects.
That's
it's
shocking.
Like just different accents. Yeah. Like pretty much the Germans say that they don't even understand each other if they come from another part. Like from here to understand someone from Bavaria.
Yeah.
Bavaria?
In Bavaria, they're speaking more like rum-ba-bum-ba-rum-ba-bum-ba-bum-ba-bum-ba-bum.
Yeah, for me it was pretty much shocking that I wasn't as good as I expected, you know? This was a shock, but another one that is quite a positive shock is the transportation system.
Oh, totally.
Like, dude, it's so
next level.
Yeah, on point. You know, like they are so on time. It's crazy. Like they say they arrive at 5:11, they are there 5:11.
Yeah.
You are there 5:12, you missed it.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, when I was living in Frankfurt, I was taking the U-Bahn and the S-Bahn a lot for going to work and whatever the heck. And it's literally so, so einfach. That means easy.
Easy.
Basically, I loved taking the public transportation. In general, like, it's obviously, it's like way better than it is in Sicily, of course. So it's just like totally next level. And then yeah. in the US, in the Very Midwest, much. You don't really have public transportation unless you're in Chicago or a big city. So like you have to have a car. So yeah, I mean, that's the other place that I'm coming from. So
I mean, a good shock, but a shock at the end of the day.
Yeah.
What was the hardest thing to get used to?
For me, it was when I came to Germany. So I came here to write my master thesis, and then after that got my job and like worked. So like for me, the hardest thing about like being in Germany and getting used to is like socializing with the Germans if you don't know anyone in that city. Like
that's
me
true.
And my fiance, we were starting out in a whole new city, and like thank God we had his brother there, and like we had like at least one person that we knew there. But like if you're coming from a city that you literally never had anything to do with,
or another country for example,
then it's just like it's harder to like meet the Germans and stuff. In fact, my best friends that I made in Frankfurt were Americans. They're American expat girls, you know.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
the other my other group of friends was like Italians working at the ECB or something like that, you know what I mean? So it was just like it's hard to like meet people.
Yeah, that's
like
true.
Like, German.
That's true. Like, yeah. I find it also quite hard.
Yeah.
Well, for me, Jesus Christ, it's because I had a whole list. Yeah, mainly, I think the weather.
Oh, yeah.
That's the thing
for
that...
For you, for sure.
For me, yeah, that was a complete different thing. And yeah. I think that I'm yet not used to. You know, like it's not just hard to get used to. It's like I'm not used to it yet.
Yeah, it's taking some time.
It's taking some time, some years, some couple of years.
Yeah.
No, but especially because it rains a lot here.
Actually, yeah.
Like it's crazy.
It's
literally
true.
I mean, of course, it depends in which part of Germany, which city you live. But here, especially, it rains a lot, and so I'm not used to that. You know, in where I live in Mexico, it doesn't rain a lot. Like every day is like around 20 degrees. So like you're used to that weather, and so coming here is like super cold or just rainy or whatever, and you're like just like I don't want to go out from my house, and I have mentioned that a lot in my videos, but it's true.
Yeah.
I can't get over it. Like for me it was a huge thing.
And like this region that we're living in right now is like the rainiest region in Germany.
Plus
it's like next level.
Yeah, so yeah. It's not nice. Another thing is the food. Dude, you have no idea how I miss my Mexican food.
I miss Mexican food too.
She's a fan of Mexican food.
Top fan.
Top fan. So yeah, I think the spices and stuff is so different in here.
It's so different.
And I miss my salsa.
I know. I miss my tajin. I want my salsa. My guac.
Yeah, totally. My tacos, you know.
Yeah.
Like that was another thing that it is. Indeed hard. Like, but another thing is that I got used to like make it myself.
Yeah. So, which is a good skill.
Which is good, yeah, but yeah, you still need it. You still need
the same. For me it's difficult to find a really good plate of pasta. You know? Un piatto di pasta,
I was gonna say.
Yeah. I was like trying to get it out. It's really hard to find some like really good Italian food outside of Italy, of course.
Yeah, of
it's
course.
Just the way it is. Like Mexican food is the best in Mexico, no?
And it will always be a little like Germanized.
Yeah.
Like the Mexican food, the restaurants here that are Mexicans or Italians are a little bit like, yeah, Germanized, you know? That's quite a thing, you know?
The food is a big deal.
Can you guys share some kind of story that happened to you here?
Okay, so a story. Where do I start? Like I have a complete list of embarrassing stories in Germany. Okay, I will go for like the supermarket one.
Okay.
The first time that I was here in a supermarket, dude, it's so different than in Mexico. Like really, the good thing is that I was with a friend because she was like the previous au pair in the family where I was going to work. Yeah. So yeah, we were like, okay, let's go do grocery shopping so that you also understand how it works here and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
And we were like, okay, we grabbed the car because also she didn't want to drive me here in Germany. So I was like, I needed to drive. And it was like, also my first time driving, which was a mess. Like she was calling me out like every 5 seconds, like you don't know this, and I was like, well, I don't know how to do it in here, dude. It's better if you explain me.
What am I doing?
Crying. Mercy. No, but finally, I mean, we get to the grocery store. We were like, we're alive. So that's a good thing.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks God. So yeah, we arrived to a grocery store and she was like, oh, can you pick a shopping cart? And I was like, yeah, of course. I went and, dude, I was fighting with the shopping carts because I don't know if it has happened to you that you just fight with them because they can't like
unstick
from each other, yeah. You know? So so I was like, I can't do it. And I didn't see the chain that is there,
you
know, right there for the coin.
Oh,
so
God.
Here you actually need a coin to put in there, like into the shopping cart, and so you can take it out from there and start your shopping or whatever.
Yeah.
But I didn't notice that and I didn't know that either. So I was literally fighting with the cart. She would just go and like, dude, what are you doing? Just gave me a coin. That's how I knew that you actually need to put a coin into it.
Yeah.
I grabbed the shopping cart, we were shopping and whatever, and then we went to the cashier.
God.
There's where I cry.
Oh my God.
So she told me very easy, like she had a bag, not a big one, actually a very small one. And we like, dude, we bought a lot of things. So she was like, put everything in the bag.
And it was a tiny little bag.
Yeah, and I was like, okay. Because first we arrived into the cashier and she like gave me a little bag and whatever. And I was like, okay, a bag. And I just grabbed it and I just stand there and she was like in front of the cashier. We were both in front of the cashier. I was just smiling like, yeah, what are we doing here? Because in Mexico, there are people that put your stuff into bags.
Yeah, in the US too.
Into cartons, you know?
Yeah.
But here there's not.
No,
I didn't know that. You do it yourself, you lazy. So yeah, I didn't know that. And I was just waiting for someone that will stand up there, you know? So I was just like this, and my friend was like, dude, what are you doing? We need to put these things. And I was like, oh, okay.
And the lady
okay.
was like, boom, boom,
yeah,
boom.
Yeah, the ladies here are so fast. Like, they are like, and then they got this huge pile of stuff. And I was like, okay, what do I do? I started to put the things into the bag, but it was a very small bag for the grocery shopping. And I was like, what do I do now? And she was like, dude, just put it into the cart. And I was just like in shock. And she was like, you just pay. She gave me the money. She was putting everything so fast because if you are slow, then you got like 10 people looking
That's
at you.
True.
They're just going at you like,
yeah, hurry up.
Hurry up. Yeah. Like, what are you doing there? So yeah, I was just like, so red. So the lady told me it's, I don't know, 35 euros, you know, but I didn't understand at all of what she was saying. Like, I was like, what?
Like,
yeah, like, vivite? And she was like, 35 euros in German. I didn't understand again anything. And she just shouted at me. She was still putting the things in the car and she was like, give her 50 euros! I was like, okay. Like, it
wow.
was a whole thing. If I wouldn't be with her, it would have been even worse.
It was your first time shopping there.
And it's so, you know, different.
The language is so like, it's so like intense when you're in that situation.
Yeah,
you're like
totally.
Shopping, you got the stuff in the cart, like the lady's like boom, 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 like scanning.
Yeah.
And then
you're
she's also
stressed.
Like, do you need a bag in German? And I'm just like, whoa,
don't do this to me.
Don't
ask
me
questions. I don't even know what to do right now. Yeah, exactly.
So it's like this.
You're under stress. Like
it's stressful.
It sounds like a such a
stupid, like easy thing.
Yeah, such an easy thing.
Yeah.
Such a daily stuff and it's actually hardcore.
Dude. Yeah.
It's hardcore.
It's really hard.
So what about your story?
Okay. Well, actually, one time at shopping at the store, I got yelled at too.
Jesus Christ.
And my cousin is the witness.
You guys need to chill.
Yeah. So this is like kind of interesting. And it's not even that big of a deal. But in the transportation system in Frankfurt, you go on the U-Bahn, you go on the S-Bahn, and on the tram, whatever. And people are silent. Okay, people are quiet.
Dude, I know what where you're
so
going.
Quiet
where you're going.
On these trains, and it's just like you get in the train and it's full, and no one is saying anything. No one says anything, and I'm just kind of like sitting there, like, you know, when you're just arriving somewhere, you just kind
of
want to observe and see what's
going
on. And like, actually, my cousin came to visit me once, last year. Well, she came to visit me a couple times, but this time last year, we were on the train, okay, and it was like pretty full. And like, you yourself, because you're living there, you notice that no one's talking.
Yeah.
And you notice when somebody is talking a lot and talking very loudly. And so
you notice from extreme to extreme. Like,
yeah,
pretty much.
Exactly, because there's no like middle.
Yeah.
And so like my cousin was just like telling me the story, like how she got there and like how she found everything, whatever. She was just telling me a story on the train and I was just like, oh my God, can you just be turn the volume down. It's so loud. It's so, and it's just like how we're talking, you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Exactly.
Like just girls, like girl normal. Talk. And it's just like when I started noticing people like turning around and like looking at us, and I was just
they
like
they look at you like,
I was like, oh my god, get me off this fucking train because I can't. Like it's just so awkward.
Yeah, like you know? I think of my, I don't know, list of 100 embarrassing stories in Germany, like 90 of them are actually in the transportation system.
This is the point. If you're disturbing the peace, then like
disturb the peace.
You're like really not cool if you're disturbing the peace. If you're like having a big party or something and you're loud in your apartment, if you're like on the train and you're talking too loud, you're talking annoyingly on the phone, like these things are not cool. Like you're disturbing the peace.
Yeah.
Like you can't
you
do
know,
this.
You know, don't do
and
that.
And they look at you, you know, they stare at you and they're just like, okay, she needs to stop that now.
Yeah, so take that into consideration when you come to Germany as well, like in the transportation. So yeah, I hope you like this video. Leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, and we see you the next time. Ciao, ciao.